In this video, we are going to see the introduction to cache coherence. When we are having multiple processes in a single system, there is a chance for cache coherence problem because multiple processes will maintain their local cache memories of unique shared memory. So when a particular processor is using a particular copy from its local cache, it will be updating in the local cache, and there is a chance of inconsistency in the information. So there are many schemes which we call as cache coherence schemes to prevent this problem. Let us consider this example. If we say the shared memory is there and the variable x with value 24. First, CPU 1 reads the data x from shared memory. So CPU will have the x value as 24. Then processor 2 reads the data from shared memory and reads it as 24. Now CPU 1 writes this value x, means it updates the value x to 32. So if you see here, CPU 2 is not having the updated data. It will be still having 24 value, and also the shared memory will be having 24. So now at this particular point of time, if CPU 3 reads the value of x, still it reads it as 24 only, but not 32, which is updated in CPU 1. So we can see that there is inconsistency in this. Suppose if we are following right through, then we can say that the CPU 3 reads 32, because when CPU is updating the value of x to 32, it is updating the shared memory also. But still CPU 2 will be having the value of x as 24 only. So there also we are not able to completely avoid the inconsistency problem. Causes of inconsistency: sharing of writable data, process migration, IO activity, input output activity. Inconsistency in data sharing. Let us say that there are two processors which are using data item x from a shared memory. Then each processor local cache will have the copy of x. At this point of time, both are consistent with a shared memory copy. Now let us assume that one of the processor modifies the value of x to x dash. At this point of time, we say that another processor and shared memory are not inconsistent with the particular processor which updated the value of x as x dash. Now suppose if write through cache is being employed, then we say that when processor is updating the value of x to x dash, shared memory will be updated, but still another processor will not be updating its value from x to x dash. So in the case of write back cache, both shared memory and also the another processor will be inconsistent with the processor which is modifying the value of x, until otherwise the block is being replaced from the corresponding processor into the main memory. Inconsistency in data sharing. If you see here, P1 is using x, P2 is having x in its local cache, and shared memory is having x. This is before update. Let us say in the case of write through, P1 is updating the value to x dash, so obviously it will be doing in the case of main memory also, or shared memory also. In the case of write back, P1 will be having x dash, P2 and shared memory both will be having the value x as it is without updating their value. So you can see there is inconsistency in the data. Then process migration. Process migration means transferring the sufficient amount of the state of the process from one processor to another processor. So here, when a particular process is being executed by one processor, after completing one particular stage, it can be moved to another processor. And from there onwards, the target processor will be executing it. Actually, the process migration will be taking place in order to share the load actually. If one of the processor is heavily loaded and another processor is lightly loaded, then the load of heavily loaded processor will be shared by the processor which is having light load or less load. So there is a chance of having inconsistency during this particular process. So if you see here, P1 is having the data value data X in its local cache, which is same in the case of shared memory, which is before migration. Now this particular process is being migrated to P2 process, and P2 updated its value to X dash, and if it is write through cache being employed, obviously shared memory also will be updated. But if you see, it is still X only in the case of P1. So inconsistency occurs in here. Suppose if it is write back, let us say P1 updated its value to X dash, but it will not be updated in the shared memory, which is being read in the P2 while executing the process. So here the updated value is not used by the P2 to perform the particular task. So again here also inconsistency is occurring and the task goes wrong. Last one, inconsistency caused by I/O. So here we'll take the input from the input devices to the primary memory only, but this copy will not be updated in the cache memory. So because of this, there is a chance of inconsistency of data which is in the cached memory and primary memory. Similarly, when we are sending the data to output device, it will be sending from the primary memory to the output device. So suppose if primary memory is not completely updated, then wrong data will be sent to the output device, but not the updated and correct data will be sent to the output device actually. This is nothing but inconsistency caused by I/O system. There are many protocols which we refer as cache coherence protocols, which will be used to resolve all these problems. Thank you.